was performing a perfectly natural, perfectly legal act. She was feeding her child. And yet you took it upon yourself to shame her as if she were committing some sort of a crime?
Clearly you haven't been listening, counselor. I told you Miss Falconeri was not arrested for public indecency. In fact, breastfeeding had nothing to do with her arrest.
Yeah, right.
Your client was verbally abusing me. That's the reason why she was arrested.
And what was the subject of this verbal assault?
It doesn't make any difference. The point
is... No. It does make a difference. It makes a difference to me. So you correct me if I'm wrong, right?
No, I will.
All right, so from this conversation, what I can gather is the two of you were at Metroport. You were breastfeeding your son in your presence, and you reacted with shock and horror. How am I doing?
So far, so good.
Okay, so when my client asserted her legal right to breastfeed her child, you responded by harassing her, embarrassing her, making her look vulnerable. Essentially, you were doing exactly the same thing that you just had her arrested for.
Yeah, you go, Alexis, you're on a roll.
So at this point, Ms. Falconeri is trying to distance herself from a hostile environment that you created. So she went to leave, and when she got up, she accidentally jostled the table.
That's quite a spin you put on the
counselor. Because there is a much, much bigger problem here.
And what might that be?
The law very clearly states that a woman cannot be arrested for breastfeeding in public. But you, Madam Mayor, have violated the law by harassing and arresting my client. And should this ever go to court, I will say exactly that and more.